I don't really know what to call this video because the content is just everywhere, so I've made bookmarks. Feel free to jump around depending on how interesting you find it and how much time you have. Enjoy. This past Monday, wearing a mask in Italy has no longer become compulsory, and hopefully this will be indefinite. In light of this, I wanted to share three main takeaways that I've learned from this long lockdown. Needless to say, these are personal learnings, but I've tried my best to generalize, and I hope you find some insights from them too. For some context, I studied abroad at Bocconi University in Milan in the spring of 2020, came back home to Rome in March when lockdown began, and have been here since. What was meant to be a memorable exchange semester turned out to be an unforgettable year and a half. The first couple of months of the pandemic feel distant to me, and this might be partially due to the fact that I see crowds and crowds of people in the center at night with cars zooming past by and everybody cheering for Italy last Friday night for qualifying into the semifinals of the Euro 2020, which is a completely different scene from the one last spring. In retrospect, every day during that period seems to have gone down the same path, and while there are a lot of media resources at our disposal, I wish I had taken more time to document the little personal deeds that were done. Whether it be logging onto Zoom for the first time, or seeing my reaction when watching the toddler stumbling into his dad's BBC interview.
For the wider region, I think one of your children's just walked in. I mean, shift it.
These small things that are easily forgotten will one day become treasured memories. A simple glance at just how much technology stocks have risen in the past year clearly shows their importance to our lives, and on a slightly sadder note, our dependence upon them. The internet gave us a virtual community to feel less lonely at home, be it spamming each other on Animal Crossing or listening to Elon Musk on Clubhouse. Technology has made our lives so much easier. At the same time, we cannot forget that phones and apps are designed, for the most part, to prevent us from putting them down. The average screen time increased exponentially and does not seem to be coming down anytime soon. And in the end, of course, the many benefits it brings to our lives significantly outweigh the harms. There is so much to be learned from Masterclass or EDX, just to name a few.
F***ing delicious.
Being disciplined and conscious of the time spent on the phone is key to striking that balance. So the final takeaway sort of extends a second, and that is, just because there's so much resources on the web doesn't mean we have to make use of all of them. Just because we're working from home doesn't mean no family time, and worst of all, just because we're stuck in lockdown doesn't mean we'll be the next calculus to discover Newton. That doesn't sound right. Just because we're in lockdown doesn't mean we'll be the next Newton to discover calculus. Although I certainly wish I did, I'd be way bigger. I still have countless hours of footage of me studying Korean, thinking I was going to become fluent in the language by the summer of 2020, which by the way didn't happen, or footage of me cutting my hair for the first time, thinking if business school doesn't work out, I'll just become a barber. It's good to be ambitious, but too much ambition will only lead to disappointment. And speaking of what I've been up to, let me now make a 180 degree turn and catch you up to date. But before doing that, let us change the setting to keep the audience entertained. I was kind of hoping I might be able to go inside St. Peter's Square and shoot, but I guess this time around there's a lot more tourists, so the police decided to block off everything, which is understandable. But I didn't want to bore you, oh my god, there's a lot of mosquitoes. I didn't want to bore you with what I've been up to, so I thought while I'm at it, I may as well take a stroll around Rome and shoot some monuments to keep you entertained. And this is going to be the same path that I took around the same time last year. So you can click somewhere here for the video. I think it's going to be quite a difference. And it's currently 5:30. I have class and work at 9 o'clock, so hopefully I get back by then. So the basic spiel is that last summer I was busy making content for work. And then in the fall when school started, so did recruiting. It was quite rough. And with everything being virtual, that did not help at all. And I just felt really down at times. Man, it's only 6 o'clock and there are so many cars on the road already. And also the street food stands along the banks of the river are also opened. So I'm excited to go back and try it because I haven't gone back in about 2 years. Anyway, then on a personal whim, I decided to take a leave of absence because I simply could not justify myself paying so much tuition when it was like watching professors trying to be Twitch streamers, for a lack of better comparison.
Alrighty, welcome back to the stream, everyone. I'm Professor Landon. If you remember, last stream we ended off with this equation.
And I mean that in the nicest way possible, because professors aren't exactly trained to teach using an online format, and I myself prefer much better the in-person experience. Italy is playing against Spain today in Euro 2020 in the semifinals, and what the organizers have done is they've set up these public viewing spots. I think there are two. One is here in Piazza del Popolo, the other one is Via dei Fori Imperiali, so right next to the Colosseum. It's always extremely hard to get tickets for these, and also by the time you're watching this, we will have known who won. Let's hope it's going to be Italy. Now, I had no idea what I was going to do during this leave of absence, but I guess high risk, high rewards, because after a few weeks' time, I was able to land my current job at the World Food Program. And it's been really rough, but also extremely rewarding at the same time. And having colleagues actually in person in Rome helped immensely. About a month ago, gyms finally opened again, and I also started taking summer classes. For the first one, I took computer science, which paired with work was hell again, but I'm glad it's over now. I also did pretty well in the class, so can't complain about that. Also, I just realized I left my mask in the car, which is kind of a problem because I need to take the subway home. Let's see if I can figure something out. All right, little update. I got my mascherina. I love the edicola here. I don't know what it's called in English, actually. These little stands where you can just buy pretty much anything. I'm taking ancient Roman history more as like a refresher for all the content I've learned about this lovely city. We're reading Livy right now, which I've done quite a few times in both English and also Latin, but I guess rereading it over and over again really just enhances my love for the city and also making me realize how fortunate I am to be in this città eterna. And what else? Totally random, but Italy won Eurovision last month. I actually have been listening to Maneskin for quite some time, so it definitely feels good to see them win. And also Billie Eilish is releasing her second album this month. So yeah, I'm super excited to see what the future holds.
A little DJ talk decided to die last minute, but just finishing up my coffee. I have a few videos planned before I head back to the States, so I'm excited to show all of you guys, and stay tuned. I'll see you soon.
But how the hell did a giant lizard get into my room? What?